Yo, CPA Strength here, back again with another video. This is like 200 days in a row or something, I don't even know. I'm in my happy place, I woke up super tired. This video is gonna be out in like an hour or something. So yeah, we're running behind, but like I'm in my super happy place. We're gonna hit 37,000 subscribers today probably. So if you wanna be a part of that, hit subscribe. You'll be a part of that. 37,000, what a blessing. So please subscribe. Also, please, you get a cookie if you subscribe too. If you like, you get good luck for the rest of your life. You'd be like a little leprechaun guy on getting his gold. I'm in the middle of January now. Yeah, I don't even know the date. I just know it's January sometime. And I need to get my stuff together because it's almost tax season and this is what I does. I was basically going over something very similar this last night with a client, longtime friend, etc., etc. Smart people pay me for this information. So hey, I'm gonna pass it on and teach everybody if they wanna listen. You're gonna start off with your name, social security, and address. When you start a job, before you get any first monies, that would be smart to do. You're either gonna fill out a W-4 or a W-9. W-4 is if you're an employee, W-9 is if you're an independent contractor. But basically both are saying, both you give them your name, your social security number, and your address. And these would be a W-4, W-9, these just stay in the office or whoever is paying you the money. It just stays in their records. Yeah, so basically you're just filling that out. This one's saying, well, there's no taxes taken out. And this one is saying, hey, it's giving you some questions like, are you married? How many withholdings do you want? Because over here are trying to figure out how much, basically we're trying to figure out how many federal withholdings to take out so you end up with a little bit of a refund at the end of the year. Over here, they're not taking anything out of the W-9. All right, we've gone over that enough. Both places, whether you're an employee or an independent contractor, right, you're working. We be working, dog. Both places, you working. Over here, you're supposed to show up at a certain time, use their stuff. Over here, an independent contractor, W-9 land. You're kind of your own guy. You come as you go, you have your own tools, etc., etc. ETC, dot, dot, dot. Then now we're down to here, whatever. January 31st, you got to send them in the mail. Whoever's paying you that money should be sending you in the mail or giving you either a W-2 or a 1099. Now, you're not the same thing, not even close, really. I guess kind of close. It's how much money, I guess they are close. How much money you made during the year. W-2 is going to have taxes out because you're an employee and you filled out a W-4. 1099 is not going to have any taxes taken out because you're an independent contractor or your own boss. The W-9 side. You're going to get a W-2 and you're going to get a 1099 by January 31st. Also, you get a copy and IRS gets a copy. You get a W-2 and IRS gets a W-2. You get a 1099, IRS gets a 1099. So they're gonna be expecting you to report that. You can't just put it under your pillow. I've done that, doesn't work. In my 20s, dog, I was like, whoa, I'm gonna get over. yeah, I didn't get over on nothing. I lost money. They got over them on me. January 31st, you got either a W-2 or a 1099, depending on if you filled out a W-4 or a W-9. Right, I put it here, the W-2 is gonna have taxes taken out. Taxes taken out, Social Security, Medicare, AKA FICA, and federal withholdings. So if you had federal withholdings back, it's like a dollar for dollar thing, you're probably gonna get a refund over here, or you might get a refund, or there's a good chance. Over here in 1099 land, no taxes taken out, no Social Security, no Medicare, no federal withholdings. So most probably you're gonna owe money, most probably. No taxes taken out, you're gonna owe money. Yeah, that's over here in 1099 land. So yeah, you've got either a W-2 or a 1099. Now you're gonna take both of these and you're gonna fill out, you're gonna take that, you're gonna take your copy, IRS has a copy, so they're waiting. By April 15th, it's not actually, I don't know if it's ever been April 15th since I've been a tax preparer. It's April 16th, 17th, 18th, it's like the days, there's like Patriot Day or something. April 15th, whether you have a W-2 or a 1099, you're gonna file a personal tax return with whether you got a W-2, a 1099, you might have even both. You might have more, you know, some people have both. Maybe you're filing jointly. Maybe you have a W-2 and your wife has a 1099 or something like that. That happens. Everybody's different. There's 300 million people in the US and there's 300 million different, you know, different tax situations. So this is trying to just basic. And of course I can ramble on. I could talk for 8 hours on this probably. Whether you have a W-2 or a 1099, you're gonna do a 10, file a 1040 with both of these, and that's a personal tax return. You start working, you do a W-4 or a W-9. W-4 would be if you're employed, W-9 if you're an independent contractor. January 31st, if you fill out W-4, you would get a W-2 in the mail by your employer. January 31st, you file a W-9, you get a 1099 by your contractor. I guess he's not really your employer, but the person who gave you money. Both you and IRS get a copy of your W-2 and 1099. So they're waiting. We're waiting for you. Taxes taken out of W-2, so you might get a refund. No taxes taken out of 1099, so you probably will owe. Exceptions to everything, of course. April 15th, thereabouts, you're gonna file, you're gonna take your W-2, you're gonna take your 1099, and you're gonna file a personal tax return, which is a 1040. Both of these guys, personal tax return, so you figure out how much you owe the government, do you get any back, do you owe more, all that good stuff. I'm in my happy place. I gotta get going because I gotta edit, upload, title tag, description, answer comments, all this stuff. I love this YouTube way too much. I'm way too happy right now. It's the first thing I think about when I wake up, so why would I stop? Anyways, until tomorrow, we're doing a mukbang Subway. I feel like I got lots to talk about. Anyways, until tomorrow, deuces.